Yeah, basically, we're going to get, it wasn't really a directive, but it was a glazing, that glazing blow would knock them out, but it cracked at the upper cheekbone, I mean the jaw, the cheekbone, got his palate, knocked 4 or 5 teeth, well, 2 of them put right up his nose. Yeah. So they wanted to get that surgery and get the teeth back in place, so that had a plate put in there, so that if he did come around and start moving around, that they would have to come back in later, break it, and, you know, get back to that stuff. And he had one slice across his cheek, which could have easily come, because the piece of metal that was, well, it was shaped, it was an L shape, it pulled, it was welded, and so it pulled off. And that jig, you know, that could have been what caused the cut right there. There's no doubt, if it had been right here, it would have been probably 2 to 3 inches higher here, or even 2 to 3 inches. You can get, there's nothing to it either. I mean, you've got these full-time years scraped, you know. Left. I heard 11 pounds, and they said, no, it's 7 pounds. Took the front and was back the window out.
He probably never did see it.
Did it come from the back or from the front?
The back. Yeah, he was telling, he was pulling down back. And was like, what I never could figure out, because, you know, we hooked him up. How can that stuff? He must have been apparently going, he must have been starting to go down, and doesn't know that my nephew, he was kind of up on a dirt pile when he got hung up, and he was dirt scraping, he was in dirt. And so that's all that I can figure. And if the picture showed you the boat, see what happened.
Well, that's why the motor runs zero, yeah, so that's why I couldn't figure out.
Well, what happened? When he passed out, or not, yeah. He hit the joystick and the motor stopped the tractor. So, otherwise, he was going slow. They probably caught him and he was headed up across the field.
That's why I asked you which way he was going.
A day in the meeting, sheriff's there. Once deputy was there within like 7 or 8 minutes. Ambulance was there within 12. And the second deputy gas. It took 3 of them to get him out of the cab. No waste to get the pound. So, you know, it's pretty tough.
Well, there's no action taken. Key finance. Yeah. We've been at this year, or was it supposed to be for 2014?
I don't know. I got the bill, so I want to know.
I think that's our first payment, because we figured that was going to have to take some of the money, because about half that was going to have to come out of our capital outlay account that we had.
Okay.
Versus, I mean, the savings that, I mean, phone system, that's the phone system.
Yeah, that's the phone. The
but why should we actually haven't even got it in?
No, but they delivered, I'm guessing, equipment. They got the equipment here in Palo, so they had all the equipment program.
I should have asked Weston about this.
So we might ask, have you talked with Weston or Kyle about that one?
Mm-hmm.
We might inquire with them about it.
Mm-hmm. Well, you have $109,000 in your miscellaneous capital outlay.
Yeah, that's what I had marked that we was going to have to take it out of. But the projection was that we had in by 1st of September, we was going to save almost half of it. Or the reimbursements from each department would cover about half the cost. But that ain't going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 100% sure that we're going to be all right for the rest of this year when we start to write checks like this. That was a yes. You say yes.
Anything else, Joe, before they start our more at all?
They're scheduled.
They're scheduled?
Yes.
Yesterday.
Yeah.
I don't know. Should we write a check? Reasonability. Your audit for 2012.
Yeah, that's just
for 2013. Sorry, 2013.
Yeah, one more year.
Yeah, Yeah, I think it was going to the last year.
They sent that reference letter to whatever the report, whatever firm was receiving them. Did you see that other attached?
Yeah, the audit will start no later than March 31st, no later than July 15th. The range is 14,220 to 15,620. It's a fee range. If we do a single audit, $3,500, and then audit related municipal entry granted per year, $509.50. That's the one thing we're going to have to watch, because that's the difference. That was a big difference, I think, between firms. Was like a lot of firms would build in, you know, like their costs would be higher than that, but they build in so many hours, like it'd be so many hours that they actually consult.
That's the way this contract is.
You get charged.
You get charged.
Yeah.
So many dollars per hour.
If you email them or call them, you get charged.
Yeah. If you have like a low bid like that, now some will include so many hours of, which is nice when you start getting into it.
Do you think any change in health insurance the last couple of weeks since I've been home?
That's a good. Do we have the data from the state? I mean, do we ever get that actual data from the state of Kansas that we requested?
I thought we did.
We haven't seen it, but I mean, I thought you said we received it, but I haven't seen anything. We haven't seen anything.
You're looking at me, and that's serious.
Well, I mean, I thought I forwarded on. Well, I probably forwarded on paid. Yeah, you've seen it because you were commenting on that there wasn't that much detail.
There wasn't their accountability to their contract. Is that what you're talking about?
I emailed it to us? Emailed it or brought it up to you.
I don't call that. I'm not calling you out here, but I have to call it towards the last page or whatever.
Okay.
I remember somebody saying that they didn't give us info on the highest, the three highest users or something like that.
What's that?
I remember bringing it up.
I don't recall seeing any. I know I didn't see any data, but I remember somebody saying that about what they left out, but I don't remember who it was.
They're needing that. I mean, my killer's needing that, so I was hoping to try and get that stuff to him this week.
99? Okay. Okay. I will let him know. Thanks, Gail. Yeah, okay. Okay. Bye.
I got the tire for $99
instead of $120.
Yeah, they won't go anymore.
I'll go down after the meeting and I'll email it. I'm sure I made copies and brought it out. Somebody made comments on them.
I just don't recall seeing it, but we need to get that data to Mike Keller, as soon as possible. Then there was some stuff that Linda was trying to work on.
Yeah, she's working on it.
How far is she into that, or how much does she have? Because I think the biggest thing was the numbers, the total personnel on, and do we know how far in she is?
She has a report. Now, state of Kansas, we have a portal that we put everybody on or something. And she can do a report that has like you and all your family and the gender. She was looking at that last week.
Okay. I mean, some of the questions I think that we have to answer probably, you know.
Well, I guess what we can do is take off the. I don't think we're supposed to do anything. We can probably send it to him and see what else he needs.
Because there's some questions that we frankly probably don't even know the answer to. Like, you know, there's some questions in detail about, you know, do we know some employees have a specific condition? And there's just stuff we don't know. We can't answer. Yeah. We need probably get that data. Is it possible to get that stuff this week? We get that stuff sent off this week? You want to put that to keep on anything in the main package, just to keep. Yeah, I think we need to find that from Wes as well.
Yeah, I
didn't. Well, let me give you a copy and I'll take the original down and put it in the file.
Yeah.
I won't have it.
We'll have to. I think it's due the first, so we'll have to make a decision by next meeting for sure.
Yeah.
Just do that first. We can pay it on the 27th.
Faster we get this done, the faster AT&T gets on the move and gets everything here.
Yep.
So
faster we enter and close this down.
Yeah. Which is completely programmed and waiting for fiber now.
Yeah, all the core components for all the offices as well as the courthouse is set up. It's sitting in my office right now. All that's left is plugging in some phones and doing a couple of data conversions as far as user inputs and stuff like that.
Yep.
But we had a technician from AOS here for 3 days last week that did all the main programming.
So, yeah, we're in, it sounds like, in detail. And we did some changes on the router to make the network a little faster, and I haven't heard anybody complain. It's not a lot faster.
Well, I talked to Jim, he said it's night and day.
Yeah. It's not a lot, I wouldn't say it's night and day.
He said compared to where they're at, it was night and day.
Yeah, so.
Okay.
Yeah. That's all we got.
Yeah, that's where everything's been going.
Excellent. We're out here.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
The new courthouse vehicle is on the way as we speak, correct, Mike?
Well, it's there.
It's there.
We'll take the hand check.
Thank you.
From what I take of this, I mean, this meeting is going on for hours. I would like to see Sheila and Pauline noted in the county. You spend the time with them, answer some questions. To me, I can turn the computer on and off, but it seems to me like it's a no-brainer. If we can eliminate some of the work, it's going to make their job easier. And it's going to be a tough corner, you know. But I don't want to jam it down nobody's throat, but I think for county-wide, it's the thing to do. That's my personal opinion.
So there's a lot of efficiencies to be made with this, and just consensus. I know we've got a couple people that are not really sure about it yet, but I mean, it seems like we have a pretty good consensus as far as, I may be wrong, but it seems like a lot of people when you move forward with this. And I know we're going to move it in stages, which I think would probably be a lot easier to, because you're rolling into some of the graduates. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think I'm fine with it.
Mm-hmm. I think it's really important you give Sheila, from a tax standpoint, the assurance that this is going to happen in 2 or 3 months. I mean, we've got to build a good window there.
Is there any criteria that we should attempt to meet that you're concerned about? I'm not sure. We can take you somewhere to look. If you can tell me the concerns you have that we wouldn't have, I can focus more on making sure I get those addressed to you. Mm-hmm. I can't control what all you've got going on in your office. I know that. But I'm more than happy to try to make sure that I'm making and have the key things you're looking for. Pretty confident I do, but yet you don't know, so I think I need to know what are your priorities or concerns, I mean.
Well, I mean, I just want to, I'd like to actually just see it how it works, how the other counties, how they're inputting things.
Are you more concerned about the finance or the payroll or the tax, or is there one? focus versus the other two? Resolve? I don't mean to nail you down. I'm just trying to find an easy way to move. Yeah. I mean, like I told you, I know what I'm doing. My girls know what they're doing. I'm just concerned about the conversion part of it, that everything's going to get converted, because I know there's other counties that went to the GRN thing and they had a mess with that.
GRN is not a Fesmanitron.
I know. And, you know, we've had such problems with our motor vehicle system. And, all the training, all the stuff that we are, I mean, it's basically all of us, probably three-fourths of it is going to be in Pauline and I's office. These other offices aren't going to have to deal with
maybe
it like we are.
I just
want to make sure that it's going to be faster, it's going to be quicker, it's going to be more efficient. It's not going to take us forever to train on this, and that we can, you know, everything's going to go smoothly.
I think part of that you'll get answered when you speak to some of those other county treasurers. Unless they tell me I'm doing something different, every Infinitec conversion that has happened on tax, I've balanced.
You will balance.
I guarantee you.
So, Barb, will you be on our conversion?
I can make that commitment.
As far as the tax goes, and that's personal property, that's bill taxes, paid taxes, unpaid taxes, distribution. I mean, that's the piece I work with the programmers.
Regardless of the training that's involved, what, and I think this is kind of where she was going with it, is this going to be a time saver considering that she has problems in her office already with another program? Is, in the long run, is it going to be a time saving effort on her part to try to switch to this compared to what she's using now?
I believe so.
Yeah, because it's internal. It's not external. The server's going to be inside our office. They're going to be communicating internally only. They're not going out to the internet and counting on two internet speeds. All they're counting on is the network to get from their computer to the server versus their computer to a router, to somebody else's router to their server. They've got a direct link.
Correct.
Yeah.
It's the same thing, basically.
In reference to Movers or Orion, that's the slow speeds and latency issues that we've been having lately and the bandwidth problems that we're having. You're not going to experience that with this. It's going to be...
But is this going to be better than Metatron? Is it faster than Metatron? Is it going to be easier?
I would say easier and more user intuitive, yeah.
Especially for training new people. You know your system, but people that are younger that you have coming in, they don't understand the code system. So, I mean... Do you feel you're younger employees and higher that you have
harder? Well, many people are going to be in here probably in the next 2-3 weeks. One of them will be.
It's true, and you won't have a new system by then. So.
Yeah. And then my other person, Mark, who's getting retired, probably hiring somebody then, so they're already in.
The people who have never used any system migrate very easily because that's all known. Okay? So, anybody who has them, that's one thing they pick up very quickly because that's all they know. The others have the skill that knows what the job is, that they know how it works on their role. And there is always a comparison to how I did it before to now. As I told you earlier, what I call is a blended software, that we have blended in the counties that we had on the AS100. We converted from every other vendor in Kansas, as well as four in-house systems in this. We have blend and make everybody kind of be like they had before. Okay. So the things that you do on yours now, I'm sure that we would have had a previous Manitron person ask for something if it didn't meet their needs. That's really where I come from. Is that I know we've had others that have come where you're from where you're at. Now, can I guarantee you're going to just love it 100%? I can't do that, Sheila. I'd like to, but I can't.
And having used both systems, which I've done, mm-hmm. I have a learning curve. And you've got a learning curve anytime you go to something new. Now that I've used the TAS system, I really like it. I wouldn't go back. I like it. It's fun.
and which seems kind of silly to say that something's kind of fun to use, but there's places, for example, on your existing system, to try to go back and get any kind of reports on a prior year. Is you can get some totals on prior years, but I couldn't believe the stuff I can get and how quick I can get it on prior stuff on the new system. There's function there that you don't have now. There's a few nice little things that, oh gosh, I like this, that are done different. But comparing the two and having used both, I like it. It's a neat change.
The ability that our users have asked us for have been giant steps at times. Is that I want to go back and I want to look at this exact record 5 years ago.
And how? Find a different year. You get that stuff.
Pull up that record in year in a different year, and you can run a report from a different year, full cycle. So sign back into the other year. So you're able to do that in finance as well as in tax. Is that we're no longer dumping data at the end of these years. It's a growing thing forward, which is pretty sweet.
Just because, okay, like you're saying, we only run it back 7 years.
And all delinquents. I should have qualified that. We have to go back and get any tax that you have delinquent. All delinquent years, no matter what. So if you have somebody's tax is due from 1971, we still got to convert that tax.
And so,
but we won't convert the rest of everybody else in 1971, just the ones that are due.
Okay. I should have gone back that far.
Yeah. And we convert the levy tax that far.
So if you recollect it, we can distribute it.
Yeah. And you know, some of this, and you might make some phone calls, you may want to go to the county, and some of this might mean just bringing in a laptop and sitting down and spending some more time and going through some of the things that you really have questions about in detail and with your staff, because they didn't see the demo.
No, they didn't.
So that is an option, too.
I learned in Pierce-sized counties, you know, as far as apps and size, it would be comparable for us to contact their department heads to talk to them.
I have on that list.
I can probably give you some out of my head that are
right.
Maybe a little different.
There were recent, maybe like in the recent times of her issues in the.
I would say Dickinson and Saline counties would be some of the more recent ones. Ellis and Barton just went recently.
Quite fairly comparable. And they went from CIC 400 to CIC TED a couple years ago. So they've been on a couple years.
Colleen, who was it that you wanted to go see? What county was it that you wanted to go see?
I would take you to Dickinson or Saline.
Saying Dickinson.
You were saying Dickinson.
And their sheriff's office works out of those two, or is it just out of
tax payers? They're still there. In Saline County, they all enter their own invoices, and also in Dickinson.
Would West and Kyle be the first ones really educated on this? So if there was questions, if they could.
We would welcome their input during the training, but we would still be the first one that they would want to follow and have support.
But we still plan on learning everything.
And
we plan on sitting on every training and knowing everything possible. So if they have a quick question that doesn't require a right, you just have to do this and this, and they're back to work versus making a phone call, and yes, granted, CIC is awesome about calling back, but if it's a 2 second fix versus a 10 minute fix,
sometimes a user will sit here and say, I
want to call them. Well, my thinking is that if somebody in house really trained, then if they did have a problem, they wouldn't throw their hands up and say, I knew it was bad.
We need at least, we would like to have someone that has the Two
when each side of this contract talking all the time. And that's a good thing. So should anything be addressed and somebody just having a really hard time when you hear it from someone, we would address them.
While everybody's here, maybe what the support costs that would be picking up each year after the initial down payment, how's that compared to what we're paying now? I realize we've got, you're going to pay it separate because you're on CIC and the rest of them.
This is slightly higher, but this has the SROs money enhancement,
which
they don't have. So if we need something changed with Thomson Reuters now, if we need something changed, like when we had stuff for SmartLinks, we paid a lot of money for that, whereas it's already in this.
This would, you would need to include your RVI.
Correct, and RVI is coming out of there, and
your STAR
for myself and for Road and Bridge. I mean, we're neck and neck.
It's not a little lower. Definitely taking into consideration all the departments that are going to be tied into this.
Yeah.
I mean,
And there's departments now that are going to save a lot of time because they're able to enter their own bills and not do four different steps back and forth. I mean, so in the long run, this is going to be cheaper and more efficient.
Lower price.
Lower price and more efficient. Right.
One thing that I'm not sure that everyone here, or you guys, that I've even explained, is the Road and Bridge applications. Right now, I know that they have to do an annual report, and it has to have all their expenses, and it has to have all their money they brought in throughout the year, and they have to report annually to the state, Department of Ag. And so they have to re-enter what's been paid at the county courthouse. Back into it. So not only did they enter it, give it to the accounts payable person, and it got paid, then they have to come back and enter it into their stuff too to be able to do this annual report. What we did is say, let's pass all of our accounting information back down to those applications so they don't enter payroll. You don't enter the accounts payable, it comes right back down to you.
Okay. Yeah, I do that too.
I think
so.
I mean, it's going to end triple entry.
So that is one thing that you did different than STAR, which is what you have because you start to all the accounting fees. We spent a lot of time, if you can't tell, what we call integrating software. It's making it go from here to here to here. Our theory is enter it once and use it as many times as you can. That's what we call efficient. If we miss a point, we want to know where we missed it. I think we've missed one. Just the recent one is Register D, pushing your receipts out to the Treasury. I think the second release that we missed.
Okay. Any other questions? Concerns? Any other questions? Okay. We appreciate everybody short time notice.
How long will we be down to?
When is the first
week?
Yeah.
How long are you going to be waiting from our side to expect me today? Or is it
going to be
today?
Well, we have a couple questions just for Kyle and Wes. We probably need Pat just to review, probably just a quick review of the other contracts.
Do you want us to get you copies of the contracts so you have a chance to look through them?
I can deliver a contract for your attorney to look through. That's usually one of the things that happens.
Yes. I think that's where we need to at least start. So if we need to negotiate or change, make any changes, provided that we decide to go forward, starting date, paying, all that kind of stuff, maybe we still have pretty clear.
In that contract will be a portion of that. We'll ask about implementation time.
Okay.
Can we meet these times? Best thing I can do is put what we guess and see where we go from there.
Okay.
Well, I talked about it already. When you know, even if we approve it, we start the implementation.
Well, so would it be before the, say the first year, because like mm-hmm. Westline and Star, we have to renew before the first year.
Correct.
So it'd be nice if we do before the first year, so we would
pay for that.
Pay
yeah.
for it.
Yeah.
Go back on the Road and Bridge.
And the Marshall
Street.
And
the Marshall
Street.
$1,000 for room and board.
See, what they are, our thinking is probably, you know, we've got a budgetary and we've got starting next year, but not this year. It's pretty hard, even though that service after payment is not that much, it's not in our budget unless we pass the weight out. Yeah, well, we can at least offer you.
Do you have a realm of mind, any idea?
As far as like decision whether to go with those?
Oh, I think once you look over there, we're sure my first doctor will make a decision. Once he looks over, we talk back and make sure all that's right.
I'm ready to try to shoot on what I would do on finances.
Yes.
I don't want to hold it for you and give it up to another one. Is that making sense?
Sure. Better? What's your time frame on that?
I have a hard time.
Okay. Yeah. We give you a yes or
no. No, we understand.
If you're not going to take them on, we'll give it to somebody else. We're okay with that.
Well, we'll work through the contract piece and just work out some dates. But keep in mind those dates are not set. We have to get something in it, though.
Sure.
So, and I want everybody here to understand that we're putting some dates in a contract.
When we put these dates in a contract, though, what we do is we are allocating resources internally that can fit that amendment. Okay? So once I do that, I'm saying for this period of time, this person is on hold because we have a pending contract. I don't want that to be a long time because somebody else may want that time I give up a sale because of that. So I want to be very cognizant that we, once we do this, we get a little bit of a hold for a long
time.
Yeah. No time to
talk
to
that
either. Do any other department heads want to go to the county and ask questions or just there too? The rest of you go okay with it? Shelly?
Yeah. I have it right now. So.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Peggy? Do you have
I don't have any questions, and I don't need the extra help to go look at another county. So.
Joe? I don't know how much it's going to affect
you. I don't
think
it'll affect me too much. I wouldn't mind seeing it, but if there's no other option out there, then I just kind of want to spend it. I don't have any of that. So. Anything's better than what I have now.
Jim, yeah. You want to talk to anybody about it?
No, from Brady Orion and having the ability to go over past years and that kind of stuff is really nice, and I'd like to see that on the bills and that kind of stuff. So we keep track of all of our bills now. We're going to bookkeeping. I'd like to get rid of that. I don't see any problems with what we're talking about.
Everything I've seen looks good for as far as Run Bridge. I don't think there'd be much of a transition, actually. I mean, I don't think
it's about a 3-day train.
Okay.
Well, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, for coming up on short notice. We appreciate it.
I'm going to
Thank you.
That's not good news. We made an interest-free loan with a carrot for 12 years. That is not good news.
Okay, we're getting in.
Oh, maybe this way.
Hey, boys.
You're right.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Yeah, thanks for bringing one. Yeah, I'd like to.
Ma'am?
Sex, too.
If you decide, would you set something up for Paul, Pauline, Sheer?
If he would like to go to a county, I'd like to make sense with him. And I've done that before. I'm not in the room when they talk. I'm just there to direct them. So this office, you're probably going here because they need it, and I want them to see the work for you, not the department head, the person that actually knows it. And so I'll step out in the hall and do their thing. And when they don't look at something else, I'll take them to another office. But what happens is a site visit without us present, they can get a misinterpretation that that's the only way it works, is the way they do it. And come out, I don't want to do it like that. I'm there to say that's not the only way to do it. And it kind of helps us. We don't have a misunderstanding. So I'm willing to take them from there and be there while they're there. And I really best. We can schedule a time when they're available and meet them. Maybe in Abilene.
Yeah. And I told them both that I'd take them to whatever county they wanted to go to.
The symposium was an ideal opportunity to meet these people. From the IT standpoint, the conversion, we went down and met with people from other counties and talked about their pains and what headaches they had going through the process or training issues they had. And it was really nice to meet with other people that had this and talk to them in a not a strict sales visit fashion. Sit down and meet with somebody and discuss it with them.
We opened up a full client base.
Just get a budget.
It was our invitation.
Yes.
I like your use of the word Thank you.
my goals and plans are just like the demo, just sit through everything and try to absorb as much as possible, so you don't come to a screeching halt or stand still over it. Oops, how do I do this? That way we have a first point of contact that's on site or across the hall or across town, you know, where we're at. And that way they don't have somebody in front of them trying to pay their taxes or renew their plate, but are getting frustrated and waiting and bad mouthing the county while they're waiting.
Thank you.
We've got an employee that's getting frustrated and waiting and bad mouthing the IT department for showing something down the road. Trying to be as
possible. Wonder how the chairs. All right.
That's what I needed to have, to make sure that they
know. It's going to put a lot of pressure on you, so you guys are shoulders.
Exactly. Well, it's like the farming system now. I mean, I get calls all the time on how do I do this, how do we do this, how do I do this. And since I was here for the implementation of that system, there's nothing that I can do. We don't call smart links. We call it 4 times since everything was finalized to get something done.
And they don't have
anything then? Correct. I had a phone call with Jen, well, it's supposed to be today, but it's going to happen today now, to finish it up, to get them to finish everything.
Do you have a high-speed cable there?
I need to talk to Sawyer about that.
I stopped with another young person today, I didn't think this was going to take near the length of it. What it is right now it's 6 and 10 is where the fiber is, right, from there to easement. We have to get together with Joe Bowen and FDR to find the best place. We ourselves have to pay to get a 4-inch conduit from our building somewhere out to an easement around our property, wherever we need.
Without, you know, once you get it down there and receive that, you know, so I mean, it's having software like this is, I mean, it's, of course, to me, in my opinion, is today's technology. I think it's very important, and I maybe put words in Matt's mouth, but I think for us, it would make our budgets a lot easier to prepare in the purchases that we make every year and be able to prepare a budget for the next year.
Yeah, know how much is spent on road signs and anything.
The one thing we had talked about earlier in referring to is that each department can have a receiving system of their own that can pass them to the treasurer's receiving. So you would give the initial receipt in your department. And once you pass the money and actually give the money to the treasurer, you push the money up. So it doesn't have to be rekeyed. They would have a set of ledger numbers that you provide to them that says, here's what they can put money in. So that's what you're doing in the department receiving. Thank you. And that's what I told you. I hope I was reading it on my phone.
Yeah. Yeah, I have the original proposal. I'm just here because that's going to be one of my questions. Some of the numbers didn't add up, so I'm going through here and scanning that. But I've got 2 or 3 other questions before we get out of the number crunch. And are you ready? We'll talk about the number crunch here in a little bit.
Okay.
If it's included in this update during those 5 years, like, you know, I feel like you already popped up something like a BMW number update. If there's an update to the software or program, is that automatically included in that price?
Once a year, we meet with our Kansas County, and we have what we call our user groups and so been in Wisconsin the last few years. Each one of these products has enhancements. You'll see the enhancement dollars on there. Those enhancement dollars are escrowed and put aside for each purchase. And once a year, our user group meets and says, we'd like to spend those dollars for this. And they set the priority, they determine. So what that does is
keep this software current. So for example, the software that runs in the registered deeds office, from the time of purchase, they have not purchased an upgrade copy. Because this keeps it constantly being upgraded. So my answer is twofold. There's an upgrade cost, it's built in. So should the laws change in Canvas, we have money available to share among our users with Thunderbolt. So you know what's coming, the changes in the boats and so forth. They're moving boats around and commercial things are changing. Well, we have the funding available because of enhancements to Thunderbolt. So there are ongoing updates to the program.
So that would be building, I mean, from in future use, you know, right. at some point, because once the equipment installation is done, I mean, the big bulk is done.
The installation and training is a funding of that one-time cost that you pay to get us here to install it and to train the people to use it. That's a one-time cost.
So after that's complete, then you're looking at something like the enhancements and, of course, the people that are enhancing too, would that be included in the people?
That would be your ongoing cost. $43,000 would be ongoing cost for all of it. That has the support enhancement.
That has, okay, because you've got to put down into
each application.
Each application, but that at the end of the payment, at the end of the program, what you're saying is that will be the build in for $43,000. I call it support.
Yep,
okay.
You got it.
Okay.
And I need to add one little caveat is that the user group actually controls that enhancement cost. They can vote to decrease it. Which the registered deeds have done that. They decrease their cost. Normally it starts out like 7% of the software. I think they're down to 3% now because they weren't needing that much change. And so they backed that off to pay some money. They control that. All counties pay 8% based on their size. So every participating county is throwing money in.
So it's on.
And it's a one county, one vote.
You have picked us out because we knew we'd take advantage of
it. No, I don't.
Just want to make sure. I like to be picked on once in a while, not my father. Okay.
What's kind of interesting is adding Shawnee County. They're adding quite a large chunk of money to that enhancement pot. And like Pam said, one county, one vote. So all the counties could really benefit from that kind of come on board.
So are they number 25? You said about 25.
They were 26.
26. They were 26.
You said.
And we've been doing taxes, if we're just talking about the taxes, so we've been doing taxes in Kansas for 17 years. We did them on an AM400 system prior to the PCA system. So it's not like we're new to taxes. We just have all of them that we had on the AM400 system, we have moved to a PCA plus added an additional 15 counties.
In your counties that you're currently serving, what has been the increase in these rates, say, the last 5 years? This isn't a get in cheap and house.
No, I've been with CIT for 16 years. We've had one increase in Viking, and we did not like to do that. I think it was 2 years ago. And it was a matter of logistics. It costs us more to do business just like anybody else. We do try our darndest to find ways to use technology versus increasing our support costs. And one of our latest ones that we found this year is inside of every application now you can just place your support call from within the application. There's a button at the top that when you push on it, you can enter what, in your own words, what I have going on and attach that. And it's submitted via the internet. What that did is stop us having to have additional people to answer phones because you call our office, you will talk to a human voice that speaks English. And so we didn't have to staff more phones. We used technology to keep our costs down. So that's what we look for, is a way that we can keep our costs down, not just raise them. So in 16 years, I've had one increase.
Mm-hmm. questions, concerns?
No, I was my opinion that my at the meeting I'll be that this far.
And that was
but at this time I really I had no problems with CIC, but I didn't have with the changes that you're looking at for next year, I didn't want to do anything until everything was put in place. As to what kind of software and all that. So that's the only thing I had.
Sheila, any concerns, questions?
Well, I'm kind of like Pauline. I really don't want to do this right now. We've had so much change in my office as it is. I'm shorthanded with people right now. I'm trying to hire. I've had three people leave my office. I have another one leaving in March. This time of the year, we are swamped just trying to get taxes out. I said, I don't know the reasoning why we actually have to change because I don't have any problem with the system we have now. I know it's just, I know what I'm doing, my girls know what they're doing, and all this training is going to take a lot of time for them to learn all this new stuff. And I know Shawnee County is going to CIC, but they're only doing taxes, they're not doing financial and everything else, they're only doing taxes. I talked to Barton County, they're going with CIC because they didn't have anything else but their own IT people. Pauline and I haven't even had a chance to even look. I mean, we had our little demonstration, and I'm sure they have a lot of good things, but right now, I don't think it's a good time for Pauline and I, either one of us, to do this without actually seeing how it works and how it's going to work in our office. That's just basically what we kind of told earlier at our meeting earlier. I mean, I'm sure they have some good things. Manitron has some good things. I mean, Manitron really, whenever I need them for something, I just call them up or email them. They're right back to me in 10 minutes, probably, I know they have a lot of things that I weren't aware of that they have, and I think I've said something to Wes about it, you know, about putting on our website where people can go and look at the taxes, and then they can put in a date and find out if they're delinquent, they can find out exactly how much they owe to that date, and CIC has that too, but there's a lot of things that, you know, a little presentation that they presented, it was pretty quick, I mean, you know, you just can't take all of that in. And my girls have been beat to death with this motor vehicle system, and it's still having problems, and, you know, it's just, I think it's just too much with everything that's going on in my office. We had a new time clock, and then the new phone systems, all that has to have training. I mean, it's time consuming, and we just don't have time. We're busy.
What's the average time to train somebody to use the system? Because I know Manitron, correct me if I'm wrong, it's like a DOS based, it's code, it's a DOS based system. What's the time relative to each other, like as far as training? So if you're training somebody today, and you have the AS400 system here, and we have a PC based system here, is there a way we can, I don't know if you can answer that, or I mean, what's the training time to try to get us an apples to apples comparison as best we could as far as. So I'm not that familiar with DOS. DOS is.
I can't really speak to what someone else's training time is on, like Manitron. I can speak to what ours is. Is that what you're asking me to speak to?
Yeah, or even, I don't know if anybody else has the experience with both.
I've got experience with AS400, and when I had experience with it, it was about 5 years ago. 6 years ago, when it was a little more common, we saw a lot of retail places that still controlled their inventory and did a lot of invoicing and ticketing from it. And I can tell you that with today's technology and our use of computers and the way it's changed over the last 15 years, that it's 3 to 5 times faster to learn a PC-based system than a text-based system because it's what everybody's familiar with. When you sit down in front of a computer and, like, for me to work on a computer and bring up command prompt, a lot of people's eyes glaze over and look at them, like, what are you doing? I mean, it's our way of troubleshooting, but it's not their way of using a computer. Because, I mean, you sit down at a computer, you click on icons, and you run a program. You don't sit down at a computer and open a command prompt and execute commands. You're used to, and in my words, I call them flashy widgets, because you see a picture, you know what it correlates with, versus typing a text command or using a keyboard shortcut. It's just the way technology's changed and our use of technology's changed.
Probably one of the best explanations is you're not learning a new job, you're learning to use a new tool to do that job. And the primary thing is, if you know the job, you just got to learn the tool to do it. And so people are so used to using the mouse and the PC, so that is that's narrow work for itself. I remember when people first went to PC. And that took off the old green screen. That took some learning. But that's second nature to everybody now. So you're basically learning a new tool.
Your entry screen is a little different. But your outcome, like I said, is the same thing. Here is, when we go in and plan a transition is from this software to this software. We have a schema of what we anticipate training. And so, can I just give you a scenario here for like security setup, and this is in the finance system. It's about half a day, and they include the appraiser clerk and the treasurer and the IT department. So, cash receiving entry is about a half a day, and I'm talking 4 hours. Accounts payable entry processing, that is the full process from entry all the way through, would be 3 days, but not everybody's going to spend 3 days, so it's usually a morning workshop for the department, and away you go. is that giving you kind of what you want here? Miscellaneous disbursements?
Kind of, so as far as doing something like that, though, I mean, you can only take so many people out of house at once.
We
so.
Cycle. We usually have a morning workshop and an afternoon workshop.
Right.
And so hopefully we can, and if that doesn't work, we also find out in doing that that there's some people that require more assistance than just the workshop.
Right.
So we kind of go out and want to do their first group of things. All first-time processes, we want to be here with them. So the first time they run accounts payable checks, the first time they do payroll, we're going to be here for those 9 processes to get them through those.
First distributions, all of that. And the trainer comes with a follow-along person. And so they go through and they do the training, and then maybe the trainer's moving to a second group of people to train. That follow-along person sets with the last group and just watches over their shoulder, answers any questions, and helps them along with what might come up. So you actually get 2 people in on everything, doing training on everything.
There's written manuals that tells you step by step, which is a task-based thing. The task is, I want to enter an invoice. You do this. That's the task. It's not, what does this menu do? It's what does the task take you to do.
So you do a mass training, and it's about 4 hours.
And then we come down and individualize to you.
Okay.
That gives the biggest concept as quick as we can to a group.
Mm-hmm.
And make sure each one of them learns the skills they need.
In my office in Pauline, since we haven't done those trainings.
You have like a great deal of it.
Yeah, a great deal of training. That's what I'm saying. It's a lot of training in my office. And we had a lot of training with our motor vehicle system. And it still wasn't enough. Let's get everything ready, all the conversion problems.
I'm not the motor vehicle system.
But, I mean, there's going to be.
I know you have been burnt. I know, and I really want to say, I'm not sure.
You know, I think each department has a benefit and then have a downfall. And between Pauline and Sheila, probably going to have the biggest downfall because they're the ones that actually use that system, current system, every day right now. None of the rest of us use it, as far as I know. So none of us are actually doing any of that. We're doing the old paperclip way, So until it gets there. But I think in the long run, I think it's going to be the best option, some new type of software for, whatever it is.
If you have all these kinds of things, we're not against doing it. We're just against doing it right now until we've had a chance to look at it,
boom to that system. There are parallel processes, and the best way to implement this is not all at one time. And the best phrase I can say is you can't swallow an elephant whole. You got to break it up in pieces and manage it. And so each one of these would have a timeline of when can they go and a plan. And inside the contract would be delivery dates that you anticipate and when this would be done by. And so when do we convert it, when do we deliver it, when do we train it, when is it completed for each one of these. And accounting, everybody thinks accounting is the best to start the first year. Not necessarily. We can start accounting any time of the year. We can jump in the middle of a month if we don't even have to be in the month. So accounting can go anytime. Payroll can go anytime. The one who is the most cycle type software is tax. Because it cycles from him to her to them, and there's always a process going on. And there are some opportunity windows. The opportunity windows are the first of the year where the appraiser comes on and works renditions. And the process starts as a new tax year comes. That's one opportunity. The next opportunity is kind of in June when they certify, because it's a time when everything kind of stops and everybody certifies, and we're at a point of balance between the appraiser is certifying to the clerk this year. We're at a point of balance that we can pick up and go forward from there. To me, those are the two best times. In between, you can get into the August time, but it's a little bit tougher. But those are the two prime times. Okay. Don't go in November.
For the appraiser's office, right? Not my office.
Let me cycle that. You have a good point. Let me cycle that. So if the appraiser came on in January, I'm just going to say, now, we would probably do your finance first. Finance first, because everything comes to finance. Then payroll. And then probably motor vehicle. And then some of these other ones. But I think tax will be your last install. Okay? Now, when we say tax would be the last install, if I cycled it with you in next January, not even this January, but next January, you would come on, you would stay on your old system and collect the taxes that were given to you in November. Pauline would come on at certification time, and you would come on after the second half is paid. Because you don't want to take those group of payments in both systems. So it's a cycle. Cycle you in on your system.
That makes sense.
So it's not all at once.
It's
brought in
and does that make it better? Because it looks like I've seen some heads like this and a couple like this. For me, I'm just trying to do, you know, what's the best for the county and get it running more efficient and more up to date. And I know it's not going to please everybody.
My question is, do we have to do them now? I mean, is there a reason that it has to be done now? Is there a way that, I mean, Pauline and I can even look at another county first before we even make
it? Well, I think we've had that offer out for quite some time since we've been talking about this.
Since it's been a year that we've started looking at this. I mean, we've been going through, I think, most of this year.
When did you guys come in and make your first presentation?
June.
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 Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Sheila wasn't able to go down to the user conference, which was unfortunate for her, but I mean, she couldn't get away. And, hindsight, I should have just got her out to a county somewhere when she had time. Which, everything takes time.
So, right, one thing that I know we have now, correct me wrong, we have two sets of books that are maintained, is that right? We have essentially two sets of books that are maintained in the county. And so this would be essentially, we would have one set. Is that right? This system will allow us to have one set, which, for us, there's different balances on two sets of accounts, so it makes it pretty difficult, at least on our standpoint, when we're looking at the ledger balance sheets that we're getting, because we don't know if that's good year over year, month, date, I mean, so some of those balances, I think, would probably streamline, at least on this group, on our side.
Our system was designed with the assistance of three auditors, and two of them are Kansas auditors, one's a national auditor. And the theory was that you don't ever remove your check and balance. You have to have it. But the system knows the details of what the treasurer collected and what you put in as receipts. The treasurer, or the system also knows the money we spent through accounts payable, through payroll, any money going out. We have money in and money out every day. We also run a banking system, bank accounts, investment services. So at the end of every day, we know how much money the county has, we know what bank to spend and what account we run. And we also know what funds belong to. So the next day, we start with that balance, and we have the receipts, we have the expenses, and somebody enters a summary record that says, I've looked at these and I agree. They pass probably an envelope now between you. Do you pass?
Yeah,
okay, so the daily statement's been passed between them now that they're agreeing on. They're just rekeying it into their various systems. Well, we don't rekey, we just summarize into one screen and we agree. So we have one set of books that's still an agreed upon set of books. So every day you're in balance. Not at the end of the month, every day you're in balance. And you move forward. So there is really no end of month in our system.
What about end of year?
There's maybe a four buttons. You create the next year's account numbers. You move the budget to next year. And start the beginning balances. And you close the fund balance. And that is from the revenue account. It's about a 2-day process for a year in our payments.
Now, within each department, we could set up the amount of detail that we want within our accounting system, right?
Yes. I'll answer that. Somebody still has to manage the accounts.
Right.
And yes, you can have as many objects as you need to account for the detail that you want.
Okay.
You can even have sub-departments. So, for example, I can have fuel. I have diesel and I have gas.
That's
the one
we're going to go to. Okay. So that's up to us to determine that.
It's at the county level in the book. So maybe in your department, you just want to use diesel. You don't want to use gas, but you wouldn't add that in your budget.
Great.
The accounting system, again, was developed in Kansas, but it runs in 5 states now. Tax can't run in different states, the Kansas one
as part of Road and Bridge, I don't think there'd be a great deal of learning because I know Terry and we had a good understanding of it just after
the learning curve is very
just from the demonstration we had up here. And I'm kind of like Jack, I'd be excited to know, to be able to just look in there and a great example would be when I was trying to trying to determine whether we should go on 5-year grader plan, and I was trying to figure out how much we had spent in repairs on our old grader. You know, if you could, without sifting through a pile of papers this deep, that would be great.
Yeah, it'd be huge for us too, because I do have a system, but it's all Excel spreadsheet now. And I'll enter all of it. So it would be huge to be able to coordinate it with.
So would you be able to receive like electronic invoices and?
You can't really, they can receive one in their email or so forth, but they need to attach one to the invoice. So I'm going to give you an example. This is the entry screen for an invoice. And I put the vendor number and I put the invoice date and I put the amount and I can attach. So I would scan this to a scanner, this is a real invoice, I would scan it to the scanner, and it would associate this copy always with this invoice and save it. So then you pay it, you know what check to pay them on. Later on, I'm searching vendor history, and I search this invoice, and I say, I want to see the image. This comes back up. I can do that whether I sit at your house, or in your office, or your office, it's always associated with that, and they're on. That's the big thing. Does that make sense? Very lucky. That's what you get. You will be able to see those from where you're at. And how many of you take and you keep a copy of it?
Yeah.
And you take
the original call.
Now the original, I always remember to tell her, but the original needs to stay where the check is cut because you don't want need the original bills but what you're paying. Not copies. Copies can stay out there, but the original needs to be
cut. Copies can be on the computer. Yeah. Hand in and then you have to make copies.
True.
I can do four filing cabinets now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, more than that.
Yeah.
Not a filing cabinet.
I was thinking about that.
Do we do any EFTs right now, like electronic fund transfers? Do we do any of those right now, currently?
Okay.
EFTs?
Paying bills?
Like, yeah, like when you're paying like bills or invoices?
Right.
No,
receiving money.
We don't?
We can't. Most vendors do not like
well, I do my distribution.
Hmm.
My distribution, a lot of it is.
Electronic fund transfer.
Most of the electronic fund transfers are happening in payroll with direct deposits and stuff. Most vendors do not like you to know their bank account to put it in. That's usually their fault. We do, in taxes, like the city of so-and-so or the township of such-and-such, if they're getting taxes, we can electronic transfer their tax money instead of writing checks.
I thought the transfer occurred from, like, not you directly to the vendor, but from you to your bank to the vendor. I thought that's how easy.
Well, the bill to file.
Yeah.
But yes, the same thing with the, they don't like their, another bank account number, and then we hold them in the bank. It goes to the Federal Reserve System.
Well, I'll call you.
Can't think of that.
You ladies want to come? We're ready for you. Good, sir.
Yeah. Are you ready for me?
We are ready for you.
Based on a discussion before lunch, so they will turn out an account receivable to the proposal for the landfill typically billing. And the price of that software was $3,200. That's pretty close on the price. The installation and training, $690. Enhancements, $225. Support, $800. I didn't sum those. But there's a new proposal I just forwarded to Les's. We're doing this phone to phone today.
That's the way it works.
And, I was able to get it. That's the
Clear Meyer 0216.
The down payment is still 10% of all of that, so it makes the down payment of $22,651.15 and 0% financing for 4 years of the remaining balance.
What's the remaining balance?
The remaining balance is $203,800. I think my number says it's 35. It's right on top of my car, so I think it's
203-8635. I think so. It's either a 6 or a 0. I can't read my writing. 59-65-651. I think that's a 60. Okay, and since we got everybody here, it's probably the first time we've had everybody together, and we've done bits and pieces a couple times this year. You just want to, like, just walk through everybody, like what all we're talking about, what we're including in the CIC.
And what I
did
this morning?
Yeah.
Okay. Can everybody hear me?
Sure.
Okay. On the proposal is the a server farm website hosting. Your website would be located on our server. The tax administration solution, which includes the property tax of real estate, personal, oil, gas, severed minerals, state assessed. If you have intangibles, special assessment, neighborhood revitalization, 1620 trucks, motor vehicle, rental excise, antifada, RV, and QM, which is basically all the property taxes in Kansas. That's included as tax application. The budgetary accounting application, which is budget prep, purchasing, accounts payable, capital assets, a general ledger, taxes payable, an interface, banking and investments, daily statement balancing, cash receiving, project grant reporting, and local reporting. So that's the finance. A department portal for the appraiser to search Orion records, which is an online search of property. Also a department portal for treasurer's tax record, which is an online search of taxes on property. Indexing imaging, which is unlimited for any county office to use, which kind of replaces the RBI that you have. Instant sharing, which is a screen capture type of software. Payroll personnel. An interface to your foreign timekeeping system, the one you have now, that lets that time come into our payroll system. Public works, which includes a time management software. Remote access print, which is in the registered deeds area, which allows online searching of documents, and she can set subscribing fees to that. Lead management, and now accounts receivable. There's also a conversion of about 350,000 images that are RBI images that need to be converted into R images. It's included. The proposal has a discount, which is a 10% discount because you would have the core product of $10,938.50. That might have increased because we increased that account receivable to get a discount too. So I'm reading from my paper this morning, so I don't know if they're doing that. So that is what's included in the proposal. Okay. I asked when I went to lunch, I asked the president of the company if he would consider changing his percentage, the interest rate. And he did so because your company had been a long-time customer with Perfect Management with the CIC. Okay.
That's the deeds office?
The deeds office.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
And so, Shelley, you worked with CIC, or, well, that office.
because it did have a center right at present.
No, you're fine. I'd probably just open up questions from everybody that's here, questions, concerns for them and for us about the new system. I mean, as far as what we're talking about, it's a pretty big system, pretty big change, so just wanted to get info. We want to get input from as much as you. Appreciate short notice showing up, so. Questions do we have?
Well, you're probably aware of the Orion information on the internet is not charged anything to the county right at this point. That's provided by the state.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then I wasn't for sure if I heard anything about maps being on the internet through the CIC program.
Okay.
The tax application does have a link to the GIS maps that you have. If you have a URL that calls the map, it will link to that. Whether you put your maps on the internet is your choice when
okay.
you do it for them.
Okay. And your system does show delinquent taxes?
Yes.
Okay. Because I get an awful lot of questions in my office on that one, and I don't like the answer. So.
And the Pure Farm cost that was at the top would be to host the web, the tax inquiry, the Orion inquiry. I mean, that would all be covered by that server farm charge.
Okay. And then I don't have a separate fee for accessing the deeds from my office then.
This is not what she mentioned.
I thought that was a package deal.
Open for further discussion.
I'll
internal issue.
I will answer that fully, but normally they allow inner offices to get in there.
Okay.
But remotely, if they have some online searchers like an abstract company locally, they can get in and search. You don't want her to lose her fee because they didn't come here, so she can charge per page anytime they print.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, it's not a certified copy, they have to come in and get that. So they're getting to look, but not, they're looking online, they're just coming in. And she charges a subscription fee that she chooses to them to do that.
We use that like a lot of inquiries about that, by abstractors. I mean, do we have use that a lot of people inquiring about that?
The only, I've had a few attorneys.
Okay.
The local abstractors, they do not, they said they wouldn't use it because they prefer to come up to the office and do their search. But I think there's an abstractor down in Leavenworth, I'm sure they would use it from your title. As an attorney, so I think there's a few that would.
Yeah, abstractors we have in town.
Two.
So one of the nicest things about that is that in order to search, you don't want them to search your live records.
Mm-hmm.
Never let anybody in live records to search. So to do that, actually back up her data to our server farm, and they search there on a copy of her data. So you're getting a free backup, basically, with an off-site backup.
Isn't it backup now?
Yeah.
To it.
But there is, you know, we don't charge to back that up so we can be searched and saved over there. So some of those, that's the main thing, is that away from you. You're getting back to yours.
Correct.
This is another backup.
Correct. And all those people are in their network, not ours.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They're accessing it.
Mm-hmm.
And so we don't have to worry about getting hacked because they'll be them, not us.
Mm-hmm.
So. Lucky guys.
Or the we discussed that ad on I call it ad on program. Give me those figures.
Sure.
You know, how much will you get? Two or three things.
The accounts receivable for the software is $3,200. The installation and training.
No, it looks like the time plus this one.
No.
The full court system.
No.
Will it run a little better? The full court system.
Yeah, because you're gonna be part of this network.
Okay.
Your office will be part of the courthouse.
But the enhancement,
but none of that will change. It'll stay the same.
$25 ongoing each year.
Get
updated, and the initial cost would be the $38.90 for installation and training of the software.
Yes.
What kind of training or how much training that we get in this contract.
I had to spell out the contract, but I couldn't, I mean.
Which part?
Well, personal property that we need to worry about in our office.
Basically, per application, there's about 108 hours in tax. So it's based on the tasks that you do in your office. Each one of those has so many minutes. So unfortunately, you're less than a third of those hours.
Okay.
Because real estate's a line already. So it's just the personal property. If you haven't oil and gas here, so probably you may have most of your personal property.
Okay.
The training hours, the best thing I can say, let me explain training hours. We might quote this many hours, that's what we expect. Some people learn faster than others, but as a company, it's easier for us to train you here and take our time than to train you over the cell phone. Okay? So we will give the training that you need. Okay.
And when does Kyle get extra hours to help us when we forget?
Absolutely.
We're here. Yeah. Our report is 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And we do have people that come in after hours and on weekends that try to do something because it's flat.
Does it cost if we call?
No.
Okay.
I'm speaking from experience when I call for the registered office. They're always on top of it whenever you have a problem. And how have you had to wait very long?
No, ours is Rainy. She's the one that we always contact and she gets right back to us.
Even before, when Marlene was still there, I was in there a lot helping her, and they were awesome to deal with.
Table. Okay, so we're going to be now scanning and sending them in rather than all the paper and the copies, which is great. I love that. Are we going to be able to access, by department, the bills that are scheduled to be paid? So, because right now what we do is we copy them, we send them down here, we enter them into an Excel spreadsheet, then when they come out, we enter check numbers and check to be sure it's all matching and balancing.
Okay, I'm going to give you a political correct answer is you're going to follow your county's procedures. That's the right answer, okay?
All right.
What is possible, and I'm not going to tell you that I'm going to come in and change the procedures, okay? What is possible, and some counties do this, is the departments enter their own invoices directly into the system using. And they're restricted to only their ledger numbers.
Okay.
They can't get anybody else's in charge against somebody else's bill, you know, accounts. So you only get to yours. You enter those, and you approve them. And so you would attach your scanned copy at the time. And they get approved. And they go to whoever does the next level of reviewing those and then paying and processing the bill.
Mm-hmm.
But that is a procedure. But it's designed for that level of department entry. Sign off, you have a list, you can sign off. I will say that all the bills still need to be real bills at the point of pay, not a copy. You need a real bill with the person that you pay. That's just for
right. Which is okay.
Yeah.
So, just notice this department would love to enter their own because it would save all this back and forth.
What about,
we
like,
already enter.
What about like payments, like when we pay like a vendor or something like that?
That's what he's talking about. Yeah, so
they can enter their own bills. Like, if most of the time in counties, like, I'm going to pick on some department. I don't even know the department here. I'm going to pick on, like, let's say a road department would get a bill that was for four grader tires. They would call this up and they would find their vendor, put this in four grader tires. They use the description they want because that's the description we're going to give back, right? And so they have four grader tires to Foley Tractor. And they want it paid on such and such a day. And again, this is the amount I want it paid from repairs or equipment repairs. And then when you're done, you have a group of those and you send them to whoever pays them at that point. They get just a sign off piece of paper, one piece of paper that says, I agree that I want to pay these on this day. They then sum up all departments and pay the bills. That's a procedure that's in those things. I can't say change that, that's what I'm showing you that it's possible.
Rather than one person at the courthouse entering everything.
No.
And then we enter our
I
own.
Can give you a reason why we developed it that way. It's because of the time of entry. If you have line item budget that says on the thing repairs, I have a budget of $4,000. As I enter it, it will tell me I'm over budget and what I have in reason. So I get a message that tells me right then and there at entry time, you're out of budget. Given, you've already purchased them and you got them. But you might have to go to another line item, or you might think, oh, yeah, I'm in the wrong place. But the person then entering has the option to fix right there. That's why. Any other questions?
Payroll. Can I ask a question about payroll?
Sure.
So it's just going to interface with SmartLinks, which is great. Your accrual system on vacation and sick.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure Wes has looked at it.
It has many tiers based on your policy.
Okay.
The best thing I can tell you is developed for a county that had 8 unions or collective bargaining units, that people had different levels. And it can manage all those levels of different people getting different accruals.
All right. Because I know right now we have some challenges with that accrual.
And it prints up on your check, what you
mm-hmm.
have
yeah.
started the year with, what you've earned, what you've taken, what you have mm-hmm. meaning
okay.
on your check.
Right.
Whether it's sick, vacation, even if you use comp time of any kind, any leave that you want to track can be printed on your check.
Okay. And so if we have some difficulty with the way it's working, there are other tiers that you can help get set up. Mm-hmm. I think that's probably the issue that they are having now, because I have to check mine every week.
The reason
we
had to get really flexible, and some people say, I earn leave per month. I earn it based on how many years. We earn it based on days. You know what? Days are the most flexible way you can get. If you work here 365 days, that means a year. If you work here, so ours is based on the number of days and then levels as to what you earn after so many days. Between this date range and this date range. I don't foresee a problem with that.
Okay.
Any questions for me?
No, Terry and I talked about after we we talked about after we had our demonstration earlier, and Terry thought, you know, we're good. Do everything. We didn't see any problems with it.
You might have thought some.
Questions back there?
I know. I already asked mine,
okay.
So I think I'm good.
Yeah,
this is questions or concerns.
Well, you get out there and I'll start.
If we're entering our own line item stuff, like for us, we have to report back to the state. Is there going to be like a check and balance system for us then? Because like Linda will print off ledgers for us to compare.
What department are you? Health?
Community Corrections.
You have to report on a different fiscal year than your current one?
Yeah, we report
July
fiscal year. Yeah.
We handle that in the software. There is a multi-year reporting. What that means is that your county finances run January to December 31st. Sometimes in the health departments or in some of the law enforcement, they run on the state fiscal year, which is July to June, okay? And so a lot of their reporting they need to be at that period. Well, that means in some softwares that you have to add up so many months on this to get a number, and then add the numbers on this to get the rest of the number. We have a process or a report writer that goes across those periods of time. So she can run a report from July 1st to March 31st and get without having to add numbers.
Okay.
So it can do that multiple year gap for you.
Okay.
Okay. It still carries the budget at the county budget, but you can enter a project budget that can track it for the state, too.
Okay. As far as conversion, everything converting over from the old system, what kind of check and balances are we going to have to make sure that everything balance or transfers over correctly? And what kind of process, how long of a process are you looking at for that?
The normal process of converting data is that we pull a copy of your data and we bring it in an application. We don't pull everything at one time. We start with whatever application we go with first. We pull a copy of that data and we translate it. In finance, we usually bring 7 years, the current year plus 6 prior. So that, unless you want less than that, that's our standard. Okay, so when you would have 6 years of history plus the current year, okay? Then in the finance conversion, there's vendor history to balance and stuff like that. We do that first balance. And what it is there's a record count that from your old vendor history that says, I'm going to quote them just a lot of numbers. I have 19,000 records over here, got 19,000 undone. And then we have totals. We have you run reports at the time we pull data from your old system. We match those to reports on our new system. Our staff internally does that. The programmer does their work, hands it off to our staff, they verify, and then they come to you. At that level, when they come to you, it should be pretty much set that you can run reports, and we will have you run the report so you know that it's exactly the data we delivered here. You run the report and say, yes, I agree, we'll have you sign off that says this is it. That's the process through all of this. Now, as the programmer runs this and they run into a problem, maybe there's some data that's not complete out there. We might, you know, in all this history, sometimes probably a record or two that's going to be a little devil to us. And so we will give you an exception. So we did not know what to do with this, this, and this record, but they're still included in the account so we can balance. We do an awful lot of conversions, and we have converted every piece of their software. We've converted Weed, we've converted Rose, we've converted the other ones that we have before from that same vendors.
On your personal property, we do similar. We take counts, we count by year, we take valuation totals by year, and that's to get your rendition information all converted. So similar process, just a different hitting different data. Then when you get into the billing, each year is balanced individually. Total bill, total paid, total unpaid, that all gets balanced by year in a lot of detail. Mm-hmm. And looked at it a lot of different ways.
In payroll, it's year-to-date employee history. And usually on payroll, you usually bring them out 2 years prior. You usually don't bring several years because a lot of them don't have the data to bring. Did I answer you?
On the forms on personal property, people sign and bring back. Mm-hmm. Can that all be done electronically or on the internet?
As of yesterday, the answer is yes. Personal property online filing is what you're asking.
Yes, that, or even have an electronic signature card they can sign at our office that would go on to the record that they've been there.
We don't have that part yet. We haven't been asked to do that yet. We've just been asked to do online filing and personal.
But we don't want to keep all that paper anymore.
I don't blame
you.
Okay.
I'll say, I was up here earlier with them, so I just wanted to ask some questions, but one of the biggest concerns I have currently with the way we do things is, of course, the stack of bills that's sent off. Between Matt and I, probably the biggest bills monthly, I would say, probably, but there's no feasible way for me to go back and say, you know, how much money did I spend on commissary items last year, or shoes for inmates, or uniforms, or beds. I mean, without just digging through a bunch of paperwork. And I don't have time to do that, and I don't have time to have running spreadsheet of that type of stuff either, because it'd be just triple the work of what we already do now. And something where we can pull up on a computer screen and see, you know, how much we bought from a certain vendor. Now, some areas, like Matt would know how much he bought from Caterpillar, you know, on a certain machine, because the way they explained to me, they could break it down into subcategories all the way down through your budget. And, you know, commodities in my budget is a pretty broad area, from gasoline to toothbrushes, you know, so we have no way of tracking that right now with, in a feasible manner without, you know, spending tons of time. And I think being able just to be, for myself, to be able to pull up on a screen in my office and say, look, we did 160 in-bin inspections this week, you know, there's that $20 pop, you know, I don't know how much income we have. Right now, we're taking $20 in our office and tying a receipt to it and throwing it in the drawer until we bring it down to the treasurer's office, you know, I mean, there's no way of accounting for it.
County shall, with the advice of the board, and county, of course, is you, and the board is the communications board, select and appoint a director. The director shall be responsible to operate the center in accordance with all applicable law. The director shall serve in the capacity of a county department head and shall exercise day-to-day supervision over all employees within the center. The director shall be responsible to establish proposed job descriptions for approval by the Board of County Commissioners. The director shall be responsible to establish and maintain written standard operating procedures for the center to be approved by the board. The director shall be responsible for providing a monthly report to the board, and said report shall be submitted by the board to the city and the county.
So this would replace the old one that's in place. So, and so right. it's an ongoing until it's rescinded or redone, so it's not a yearly deal like an interval. I mean, it's not like the...
We adopted one in July of, in July of 1993.
Okay.
And it was certainly outdated. It provides that, for example, that the center will be located in City Hall. There are a number of things that we're just having.
And you haven't had a sign off from the city on this yet, is that what you said?
They haven't seen it.
They haven't seen
it. Trey has seen it, yeah, but we haven't gotten a... I haven't gotten any sign that it would be adopted. Or that it's agreeable, I guess I should say.
Yeah, they send them something again just to ask for trying to get it back to your approval to move forward with it.
Okay.
Because, yeah, we could approve our end and they have to approve their end, but I guess it'd be more important they approve theirs first and then support it.
Mm-hmm.
So. Thank you.
You haven't got that new grader yet, by the way.
No.
Should be.
First next month.
First October. Should be here somewhere for John.
Foley's has the agreement in hand.
Yep.
Did we set a 90 days, 120 days?
It was the minimum was 30, changed to 30. Actually tried calling us, but I couldn't get a hold of him.
We were discussing earlier, Jack had some concerns that we may get a backup in the trash, and we thought maybe that one truck that you had, transmission fix, could people throw trash in that, they just had like a few bags, so they wouldn't have to wait to get back in, or that'd be too high.
Thought we'd have a backup.
Well, you're going to have a backup dumpster, because the concern was that, yeah, if you start, even if you were away, it's going to back up a little bit, but if you had something like that where they have a bag or two, we're not going to really, instead of having them turn around and back in, the time it takes to back in, if they only got a bag or two, they could just swing it up in that dumpster, but in between the one employees to back in there, it's real high enough.
For a dump truck?
Yeah.
I thought it was.
Can people get that trash up high enough for whatever it is?
Well, that would be the next deal.
That's pretty tall.
Yeah. That'd be close to 10 foot probably in there.
That's true.
But yeah, that when trash trucks, when they bring them whole off, they dump them inside the building. There's just plenty of
really high.
Yeah.
That's true. Well, I think. And Chase is aware of it. It'd be something that you guys would be probably have to discuss, and maybe through a speed outlook, be ready to have an alternative plan or something in place so that we can at least have something where they could dump. If they got real busy, they could dump something, and that's something that we could still hook into it and dump into the pit.
Right.
Because it takes about as long for some people to back in, turn around and back in, as it does load. In fact, sometimes it takes 2 or 3 times as long as that. Just back
in. What about like a 4 or 6 yard cubic container?
Still gotta have to pay somebody to hook into it and dump it. So.
That's what I was gonna say. We've got that like 30 yard, it's either a 20 or I think it's a 20 actually, out the recycle center that's ours. We can set that out there. But like Jeff or Mike said, we still have to have something out there. So we'll have the ability to dump it.
Well, we need to get something out there that we got to dump it.
I just don't see the pack, personally. I just don't see that pack. I've seen the volumes getting slammed up there to adjust
you the volume. You may be surprised. I understand what you're saying. All the take, when you get to transition into something new, and if there's a least bit of a little glitch here and there, you're going to start hearing a lot of complaints. All we're saying is if there's a, get their PO, but we don't want to do it right away. Maybe just see how it works and then be ready to go to the option and stuff. And we may not have to, so.
I guess they're going to deliver the scale out there tomorrow.
That's what I heard.
So Chase wanted us to have a boom truck out there.
See, and I thought they're good. They would have been furnished early.
Well, it was in the bid for them to set it with the boom truck, but.
Yeah, whatever. It's worked out, let's just get it done. Either way. Do we want to approve these while we're waiting?
Oh, yeah, let's look at it.
That's the county lake.
Oh, $3,450.
Yep, that's what he bid. So I think that was 22.9 or model 13. It was black.
It was white, what, 6 or 7 miles ago, that year there, what?
It was 22.9, so it was about 5.
Yeah, it's
pretty close.
Shouldn't they have an invoice with this?
I haven't gotten it yet.
No, they haven't got it yet. They just got the price to do it.
Oh, God, honey.
See, let me get a clarification.
So what's the price now?
It's 100, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be 100,000. What they're doing is they're crossing right here and coming up the right end and getting it over here. So, come over here to this house.
Well, it's time to be 30 day a new warning. Maybe
I don't know, it's looking juicy.
Maybe that already took me more as well as trouble. Yeah, pay on that invoice on line 3, it says, this looks like a huge, I mean, it says 30 days or 1,000 miles, 100 parts, labor. But then you got listed on the new warranty. It's a new that 3 that. Okay, so it's a deal. But then when you type in new warranty, that trumps that, right? Okay. Right. Oh, that's 100%. Okay, that's what that is. Okay. All right. That's all we needed to answer. All right. Very good. All right. You'll have your check the second Tuesday of next week. Okay, all right, bye.
100 digits, honey.
That's 100%.
For me?
Yeah. That's 100%.
That pays. Oh, right.
The first 30 days,
100%. Oh, okay.
And that new warranty is, you said that's kind of a huge legal invoice thing.
I can't remember what the new warranty was. Do you remember what it was?
Well, I think Ford's only 36.
36.
3 years, 36. Our max would be 550. That max. Ask Pat what his was. It should be the same.
Which one? Oh,
right here is getting
on Ford.
Four. Are they 3 and 36? Or 550?
I don't know.
He just
got
the
hook and haul
it. His wife told him about it.
Yeah. He didn't ask the question. He just signed the gift. Look at it.
The price looks right.
I don't have to answer that question.
I think my makeup's 4 years or.
It's a certain 50,000 or something. Check it out. Order for rain and all that good stuff. Of course, you pay for all of that for us.
So, do a motion to authorize me to sign the invoice for Foster Ford Inc. for purchase of the 2014 Ford Escape. Then on the $23,450.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
I second it.
All in favor, signal by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay, 3-0.
How long does that take to go through the system, or can we do it? I mean, what I don't know what our need would be.
in agreement that...
The only question I have with that, 3 years down the road, we decide to move that road over, do we have to request that or...
No, it's right here, the utilities, it's right there. The said utility will move, lower, alter at any time if necessary for road construction, as approved by the county, without cost to county or townships. So basically it's on. And if we ever do any damage to this, or 6826 road.
Need approval to sign that?
Yeah, I think all three of us can sign this.
Unless it's why it's right there. Second motion, I'll give it to you.
Okay, second, all in favor, some of the things that...
Aye. I didn't know what to talk to you.
What was the way it came up?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it came up again.
It came in?
Said she left.
Oh, okay. I told him I'd talk to her about it.
Okay. He just came up again.
A combination.
Also, I've got a PO here for, used motor we need for our water truck. It's a 3208 cap for $2,500.
Use that motor.
Yes, good run. And that goes in what? Our water truck. It's using about a gallon of oil a day, and it dropped a exhaust valve. So we found this motor for $2,500. We went and it's still in the truck. We listened to it run. Sound good. Look good. So.
As
far as I know, it's a one-time deal, according to those who... stations. Yeah, there's the back two pages of the letter from the state saying that we had to have a loan. But you asked her if that's what was brought up. Said you can have that copy.
Yeah, I mean, I knew we'd done something with it, but I was just trying to figure out like future costs of what's going to occur. I can't remember exactly what we're doing.
To go forward with that, they have to do a survey on the transfer station out there. What they need to know, the legal description of everything out there at the transfer station. And so far, I talked to Jim Lamp yesterday, we can't come up with what we need. So what we need to do is have a title search.
Do you need to get the last track?
Yeah.
I have it in my home.
Do you have
them? On the D.
Well, that's what Jim said on it. Come talk to him, but okay, I'll get with you later then. If Pauline doesn't have what we need, we'll probably do a title search, which he said would be about $300 or something like that. But hopefully Pauline got it, so I'll get with her.
We should have a copy of the title, shouldn't we?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't know when that place was, probably in the 70s or earlier, probably when it was bought.
The deed should be recorded in the Office of the Register of Deeds. But if the deed may say, you know, the northwest corner of Section 8 or something, yeah, they may want a deeds and bounds description.
Yeah, they need. So
we might as
well, they actually went to the Register of Deeds and told us what they needed.
It would have been 70.
Well, I don't know.
He needs the old landfill or the.
The old one.
Oh, I got both. I think I have both.
All right. Thanks. We'll get one
more.
Okay. You had a warrant?
I didn't want to pay you the bill.
Well, okay.
I left that over, didn't you? So I don't have to just show us what it was.
Yeah, but. Well, that's what I was going to bring up. I read in the paper that the city annexed the case down there.
Mm-hmm.
So we can send them a letter requesting them to take over that road, clear down to the third plant.
Mm-hmm.
And that would take care of our problem with 30 mile an hour people.
Do we need a resolution for that?
I think the statute says that if we identify any of those, we just send them a letter.
Okay.
We're taking a minute to find the statute.
Just in case.
Yeah.
did that elevator stop for given that was a year ago or so.
Well, if the statute allows it, that's the question. Does the statute allow the annexation? And there are at least half a dozen ways, if not more, that an plan can be eligible for unilateral annexation. But one of them is that it has a boundary line that adjoins the city. And so most of those properties would fit that, but they're right across the street. There's a limit of 21 acres that can be taken that way. So I would think most of those places would be less than 21 acres, but there's probably one that wouldn't.
Why?
Is that wrong? I think it's a lot that.
The email of the sheriff and PD and dispatch all these.
No, I don't think Hayes is scheduled, it's a different room. I was part of that 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, it sounds like there's no need, so.
Leonard, so I guess before we jump into kicking in, Maurice, the novice, we have some. Sir?
Want me to speak now?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, okay. Okay, my name's Charles Teacher. I came up here yesterday at the courthouse to take my car that I bought in Missouri from Prestige Automotive. It is a no warranty car, and it came with all of the doors already on the car. So, downstairs they told me that I had to have the car inspected, and I had to go to the sheriff's department to have it inspected. So I went over there. Anyway, there's a gentleman before me. So he went ahead and took care of his business, which he needed his vehicle inspected as well as me. So they went ahead and did his paperwork, and the lady went outside, you know, took care of his inspection. When she came back inside, she asked what I was there for. I let her know that I was there for the same reason as the previous gentleman. And she goes, all right, so she let the guard tell her know that she buzzed back inside her office because she has no keys to unlock the door. When she gets back inside, she starts doing paperwork and everything. And after that got completed, my understanding is she was going out with me to inspect the vehicle, which is a 1997 Mercury station wagon. And we got all the way out there. Well, no, I went outside. Sorry. I went outside and I was waiting, but instead of her, it came Captain Wright, and he came right up to me and he asked me which vehicle was it, and I told him it was the white one, which my car was the only white car out there. So he pretty much got all the way to the car, and because of my disability, I can't, you know, run all that fast. But he got to my car, and after he did the VIN on the dash, he asked me, how did I come by that? And I was like, what do you mean? And he goes, the disability placard you have. Oh, and I do have a disability. Anyway, he goes, I need to open up the door. He opens up the door. The door change. He goes, okay. He goes, you'll have to get the highway patrol to inspect your car.
You set the door, what? Door change. They changed the door.
Yeah, door change.
Okay.
All right. Because the VIN numbers did not match the ones on the dashboard.
I see. Okay.
So, anyway, he let me know that I was going to need to have it inspected by the highway patrol. I asked for a number, and he jotted down the phone number and posted it on my title and everything else I got with the car when I bought it. And after I retrieved everything, you know, my title, the phone number, and the $20 that I already given him for the inspection, you know, I left. I went home to where, you know, I was at home with a pen and paper to where I could jot down anything that the highway patrol was going to tell me. So when I called him up, and I told him that I needed my vehicle inspected by the highway patrol, she asked why I told her, and she pretty much started laughing, and she just was in complete awe that, you know, that the county sheriff's department could not do a simple door change, as she put it. So she told me to come back up here and let them know that it's all right to go ahead and do this inspection, and if they need any help, to let them know, hey, just give us a call.
So did she call somebody up here?
No.
Okay, so he told you to tell them it's okay. Is that right? That they can go ahead and do it?
Yes.
You mentioned something, the fact that it was okay for them to do it, but who gave the instructions that they don't need? Because they apparently told you that you needed to go to the highway patrol.
Yes.
Right? And then she said, no, you can get it done here. So
change. All they have to do is call Highway Patrol and, you know, they'd be happy to go over it. So anyway, while I was telling her this, the gal that I had previously dealt with on my first trip here, she was whispering the whole time, just like 6 to 8 inches away from this new lady that was waiting on me at the sheriff's station window, which this one is sitting off towards the right, and the other one was sitting off towards the left. Well, anyway, after that gal got done whispering to her and everything, she told me that she then let me know that they sent me to the highway patrol because they just didn't like my attitude, and I laughed because I certainly wasn't aware that I had any attitude. And she said that the sheriff's department was a private unity away from the highway patrol, and they take no orders from the highway patrol because they are a private unity away from the highway patrol, and they have the right to refuse service to anyone, and they are exercising that right with me. Is exactly what she said, and I left, and when I got home, I called a disability rights attorney, and what he told me was it is the state law that they have to either inspect it or make arrangements for it to be inspected so that I can go ahead and get it taken and set down. And when she told me that she didn't like my attitude and they was a private unity and all this, and that they had the right to refuse service to anyone, and she was exercising that right with me, she just made me feel like a total piece of shit. I mean, there was no excuse for that. And I had no idea on what their problem was, but when I let Captain Wright know that I had a disability, for me to have the disability placard, you know, he just kind of like, I mean, you could just tell that he just didn't like that I had that.
So where's your status on that now?
I don't have an inspection on the car at all.
Do you have 30 days?
No, it's done been past 30 days, so I need to have it legalized because I have received a ticket on the tag.
So was 30 days up before you came in?
Yes. The 30 days, I had a 95 Ford truck that I used to have, and I'm using the tag from it on the car. And so I'm just trying to get
you
this.
You get it inspected? So you
yes.
Okay. Did you talk with the sheriff?
No. No, I just, after she told me all that, there was no way I was going to talk to anybody up there because that just totally, I mean, are we like back in grade school again? You know, just because you don't.
I'm sorry, let me get that. I think we appreciate hearing about it.
Uh-huh.
We will make some inquiry, maybe to follow up. But the sheriff is an elected official, and so this board doesn't have any authority over the sheriff's personnel.
Uh-huh.
But we talked to the sheriff about it. I think we will do that.
Mm-hmm.
But we don't have any authority. This board does not have any authority to take action against an employee of the sheriff because the sheriff's an elected official. So I would suggest maybe make an appointment and talk to the sheriff about it as well.
Yeah. Well,
this.
I was told from the disability rights attorney to start with the county
tell us about what happened.
I'll just let you be completely aware of what kind of people that this county has working for them. Because, I mean, what, we get to pick and choose, you know, who we get, who we have to wait on, you know, at this very minute, you know? I mean, somebody comes in to pay their property taxes or something, you know, you're just going to stand there and say, hey, you know what, I don't like you, you know, go somewhere else. And that's exactly what they did yesterday. I just don't like you, so get out of here. And I don't think that they should be allowed to be able to work on my dime. Because that is insubordination on the job. So that's all I got to say.
I don't disagree with what you're saying. I just hope you understand the position of what the chain of command is.
Yeah, well.
So.
Okay, yeah, I understand.
So we're aware of it. Like,
yeah.
You go through the channel.
Okay.
If you want to talk to the sheriff right now, you probably should go out that door. So if you got this one, you have to walk around the front and hold it around. But if you go down this door and down the stairs, you can.
Trower, T-R-O-W-E-R.
Thank you.
Okay. Just, I want to thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Trower.
Thank you, Fred.
Yeah, we're going to discuss some of that. Probably needs to be an executive session. Personal matter, not like personal.
I think the channels have to be in. We go through the proper channels and then we can address it. So.
Number one, if the highway patrol said get a hold of them, why didn't they call and say what's going on? I see where they can't go with somebody's.
I would really suggest going into the executive session before we're going to talk about it more.
Correct. Real quick, 5 minutes.
We could do that.